Hi, so post-surgery recap, I've just been resting the past few days and haven't really been able to use my hands or arms that much, and I basically have to sleep on my back and wear this massive breast chest thing. That's my titties. Those are my titties that you can see through the bra. And I basically have to sleep on my back with this the whole time, all the time. And it's making me super stiff and I hate it. And they didn't tell me I need to do this for 3 months. Have you had breast surgery? Did they tell you that before you got breast surgery? I think if they told people that, they told people all the things you gotta do, then maybe people might be like less likely to take it. I don't know. I mean, they do cut you open and it does cost a lot of money. So maybe that's irrelevant. So how do I feel? Well, the first thing is, I feel like these are props. It just feels like I woke up with some lumps on my chest and it doesn't really feel like it's mine yet. I feel like it's like anything new in your life, you know? When something new in your life comes in, it feels not necessarily a part of your life. It just feels like it's there and it's exciting, but it doesn't feel like it's integrated with who you are or your life situation or where you are. For me, these boobs feel like lumps. They feel like props. They feel like things that have just been placed here and are kind of just in the way, causing me, you know, all these other things that I need to do. So I understand that there's an integration piece. However, being able to touch them and see them in the mirror for the first time was a really touching experience and really opened up the realization for me to see the change that I've been doing the inner work with, the change that I've been doing inside is now starting to also have an effect outside. And so these breasts for me are not so much just getting the breasts and being done with it. They're more symbolic of, I have taken the steps to transform and I've done the internal work, and here's an external marker of that internal work. And that's all any surgery or any kind of external physical world changes are. You can put on a dress, you can get boobs, you can change your face, you can get a vagina, you can get a, you know, you can get a dick, you can do your GRS, whatever. Those are just, you know, I hate to say it, but props. You know what I mean? Like, they're not necessarily like, you're not just getting a real part that's just going to be a real thing and that's it. You have to engage with it. You have to say, you know what, this is my boob. This is my new face. This is my new part of my body. You have to use that as a gateway to activating and accessing a part of you within inside yourself that gives yourself permission. And this is key. Do you know what I mean? Giving yourself permission to say, yes, I am a woman. Yes, I am a man. Yes, I am whatever I want. And yes, these are my boobs. Yes, this is my body. And that ownership and that permission to give yourself, no one's going to give that to you except yourself. You've heard this a million times, right? You're the one that gives yourself permission. No one else is going to give it. Don't wait for anyone else to give you your permission to do whatever you want or to be whoever you are. Go do it. Be whoever you are. You are the person that's stopping you from doing whatever you don't want to do or whatever you do want to do. And so what's really magical about transformation and transitioning is this interplay, this cycle of the external and the internal. Like, I don't think people would be listening to me or even interested in my topics if I just looked like a cis man and I spoke like a cis man and then I was just like, hey, like, I'm trans and I'm a trans woman and blah, 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 blah. No, like, they need to see the external indicators, which are indicators of the internal change. And our relationship with the external things helps us change our internal self. If I were to tell you, here's the gateway within your mind that can, you open this gate, you can change your perception of yourself, you can accept your body, you can get rid of all your gender dysphoria, et cetera, et cetera. You would take that, right? What would you do? What would you do if I told you that? You would take that. But like, to find that place within ourselves is a mysterious thing. It's not something you can just like find a map for and just go get it. But by doing things like getting breast surgery or what I'm going to do next, which is face surgery, those are physical changes that give me the ability to find that gate within my mind that gives me permission to access that doorway within to change and transform. This is the important thing though, and I really want to emphasize this because I'm sure you think it too. Surgery or any kind of hormonal transition is not a requirement for transitioning or being trans. You can do all of this work on your own internally. That's all this is. All the external change is just a way of getting to the internal change. It's maybe a shortcut, but all of the internal change is internal. Like our entire universe is really internal. Like you close your eyes, if you're blind, if you can see, you can feel, all these things. Like what would your world be? It would be all inside. And that's the thing that matters the most is our experience within us. And like, I find this to be the most fascinating thing about being trans is you go into the galaxy within. You know how they talk about how the ocean is like, we don't know much about how deep some of the stuff down there in the ocean is. We know less about the bottom of the ocean than we do about space. It's like the same thing. It's like you can look outwards into the external world, but there's also this internal world, and it just goes deep and deeper and deeper and deeper. And this is some of the spiritual stuff that people have been studying for thousands of years, you know, with Buddhism and other kinds of religions, the meditation, the mindfulness, going within and finding enlightenment or finding the path for one's own being and one's spirit, one's soul, one's experience. Like that's the magic. And that's what we're kind of doing here. This transition is a journey within and finding who you are, where you really stand, and that space of truth and allowing the being that is all of you to come into this physical external reality. And the interesting thing about that is once you come into your body, you come into your mind, and the internal has blossomed and allowed that internal blossoming to exist in a physical body, you are now an external thing for other people. And now you can trigger other people into understanding themselves, into going deeper within their own inner alchemy. So by changing myself and by sharing this message, it's my intent that I hope you find ways in which you can change and find those things within you that enable you to blossom and you to grow. And by doing that, you're also going to be triggering other people to also do that. Now, there's this whole side of people being triggered in a negative way. And yes, some people don't want change, and that's a whole nother topic. But let's look at the positive light. Let's look at the magic. Let's look at the things that we can do to help other people in this world. It's to create the change within, to show that, and to become that external trigger for others to then look into their own internal world. That is the magic of transformation, and that is the magic of going through this change. And all I'm doing with this surgery is I'm just playing with myself in this external, internal thing. You know, when you get gendered right, you know, when someone says you by your chosen name, like those are just external things, but they latch. They like open up this doorway within that gives you something special, that gives you that gateway to walk through and step and be who you are. So that's all I had to say today. I look forward to seeing you tomorrow. Bye.